A new case, new hardware, and a new set of options catapults the Corsair One into the modern day. But a fresh look and updated components aren't the only thing it has going for it. The new Corsair One i500 is also getting the Origin treatment, which means we have more to look forward to. Not that the Corsair One wasn't exciting enough. So just how much customization does Origin offer, and just what is the difference? Well, you might be among the first to find out right here, right now on Robeytech. When the Corsair One was launched back in 2017, it had a singular goal: to deliver the pinnacle of gaming, VR, and workstation performance in a minimal footprint. It was compact. It had like a super sci-fi vibe, and it was packed with the generation's best hardware. Get this, I'm talking a Core i7-7700K, a GTX 1080 Ti, and 16 gigabytes of DDR4. Woo! But back in the day, that was smoking. Okay, this is the part where half of you are like saying, okay, grandpa. And then I reply with my best Deckard Cain, stay a while and listen, because we've come a long way since 2017, and so has the Corsair One. Not only has the newest addition to the Corsair One family, the i500, received an upgrade to current gen hardware, it has been completely redesigned to improve cooling and user upgradability. And if that wasn't enough, the i500 can do something that no other Corsair One has ever done before it. It can be customized through Origin PC. And this right here is one of the first i500 that Origin has had leave its facilities. It's so fresh that unfortunately it doesn't have any of that customization, or it doesn't have the Origin branding yet. But if you have ever had an Origin custom laptop or whatever it was, their customization is absolutely stunning. Since that's the case, this video is gonna be more of an overview of the new Corsair One, not really a review. But don't worry, we have plans for one of those. We just wanna get your eyes on it and talk about what's different if you were to get it from Origin. So let's start with a baseline. Not the funky kind that Brian and Damien lay down because they play the bass. I'm talking about the starting point for the Corsair One i500 before Origin gets to do its tinkering. The Corsair One i500 is available in two different colors and wood combinations. Yes, I said wood because it's fancy. Wood Bright has a lighter aluminum aesthetic with maple wooden accents. Wood Dark has, as the name implies, a darker aluminum look with walnut wood accents, which is what we have right here. If the metal and wood combinations look familiar, we saw this recently with the accessories for the Corsair 6500 and 2500 series PC cases, which you can see our review of and coverage of, like the 6500X right here. Now, if you want to complete the look, Corsair will also be offering customized desk mats and keyboards via their latest acquisition drop to match the aesthetics of the Corsair One i500. As for components, the i500 comes in two configurations, but each shares some core similarities. Both versions come with the Intel Core i9-14900K processor, a B760 motherboard, which is interesting, but not surprising given the form factor, 2 terabytes of NVMe PCI Gen 4 storage, 6000 megatransfer DDR5 RAM, a 1000 watt Corsair 80 Gold certified PSU, and a 2-year warranty, which I'll talk about what makes it different from Origin a little bit later. Now, the base model of the i500 has all of that, plus it has an NVIDIA RTX 4080 Super GPU, 32 gigs of RAM, and the Windows 11 Home Edition. This model, the base model, has a starting price of $35,999, and the upgraded model, which has an RTX 4090, 64 gigs of RAM, and Windows 11 Pro, retails for $46,999. Now, I probably should have warned you right off the bat, these aren't cheap. But Corsair has done a lot of custom work to make sure that the i500 achieves its goal of maximizing performance in a smaller footprint. And don't worry, we're gonna get to checking out performance in just a few minutes. Now, what is cheap, however, is a quick slap to that like button, a whip to that subscribe button, and a quick ding-a-ling to that notification bell so that you don't miss exclusive coverage like you're seeing right here on Robeytech. Okay, let's talk about some of the features that make the Corsair One so unique, starting with the case itself. As we mentioned at the very beginning, this thing has gotten a complete overhaul. Dimensionally, the i500 is 15.3 inches or 391 millimeters tall, 7.6 inches or 185 millimeters wide, and 11.8 inches or 300 millimeters deep. For comparison, the previous generation of the Corsair One, the i400, was 15 inches or 381 millimeters tall, 6.8 inches or 173 millimeters wide, and 7.9 inches or 201 millimeters deep. That makes the i500 2% taller, 11.7% wider, and 49% deeper than the i400. So the footprint has expanded from the original, but so have many other things too, including And probably the most important part, the cooling. In earlier models, the Corsair One had a custom cooling system for the GPU and CPU that relied heavily on top exhaust systems. In the old system, both the GPU and the CPU also shared a single liquid loop. However, in the i500, all of that has changed. The CPU and GPU are now cooled independently of each other. The CPU is being cooled by 120mm Corsair H60 AIO, while the GPU is being cooled by a 240mm H100 AIO with a custom cold plate to match the GPU die. Not only that, the i500 has five 120mm fans inside of this thing to increase air intake and exhaust. The i500 also features RGB lighting and effects on the front of the case that are all controlled via touch. Starting at the power button, you can slide up and select one of the 8 colors. If you go below the button, hold a finger in place and release, it will cycle through the 6 different effects, including Starry Night, which makes me happy. Unfortunately, or fortunately, however you basically sit, the lighting does not integrate with Corsair's IQ software. It's all manually controlled from the case, but I'm not gonna lie though, I'm not mad about the touch-controlled RGB. Now that we know a little bit more about the Corsair One i500 in general, where does Origin take it from here? I mean, the thing is already pretty crazy, right? On the Origin version, it will have a special Origin-specific front panel. Like I mentioned earlier, this one unfortunately was rushed to us, so it doesn't have any of that Origin bling. Aside from the aesthetics, Origin is offering expanded options in RAM, including different speeds and amounts, as well as customizable storage options. Now, here is another interesting feature which we love to see as content creators. When you customize the Corsair One through Origin, you have the option to have your system ship with an Elgato video capture card installed. Now, when we first heard about this option, it had us scratching our head a bit. We were like, So we did the right thing and asked Corsair and Origin about it directly. In a small form factor like this, it makes sense to use an ITX size motherboard, and those typically have only one PCI slot. But since Corsair made the i500 case a bit bigger, it can actually accommodate a micro ATX size motherboard, which adds an extra PCI slot for a capture card. Problem solved. As far as warranty goes, we mentioned that the Corsair One i500 has a 2-year warranty, but through Origin, buyers have the option to actually extend that to 3 years. However, the i500 will not be eligible for Origin's Evolve program at this time, which, I'll be honest, makes a lot of sense. And since this isn't a normal system, we know that one of the big questions on everybody's mind is this: how well does this redesigned Corsair One handle the problem of heat? After all, this is a small case with some really powerful parts inside. So we're gonna go ahead and unbox this thing, though we have already unboxed it, but we're gonna show you this, talk about the packaging, all that stuff, run some quick tests to get an initial idea, but don't worry, we're gonna be doing some in-depth testing in the future, and of course, doing a full review plus some comparisons against some other small form factor pre-builts that are out right now. But let's get to checking this out. Now I wanted to kind of show you something, because something that Corsair and Origin was really excited about was actually the packaging itself. This is made with EPE foam and from oyster shells, but it doesn't smell like it. It's also been ISTA 6A drop certified. So again, they want to ensure that they come not broken. So they did a bunch of drop testing. I mean, you can look at this material. This is that EPE foam. So it's very, very different. Still doesn't smell like oysters though. And then of course you can just lift it up, which it's not light. It is not light at all. You do get a Corsair One accessory kit. We'll see what that is. And I'm assuming this right here should be, no, it's the hanger. Oh, never mind, it's the Wi-Fi antennas. It's like Brian opened this already. So it's the Wi-Fi antennas. So as you unbox this, the thing that this reminds me of in a lot of ways is the Cooler Master Cooling X, which that thing was $6,000. And actually the thing is the specs for it are very similar to what's inside of this, but this is $2,000. Well, $1,000 less than that one was, but the materials and stuff like that are pretty cool. I've always wanted to test a Corsair One, but I've actually just never had a chance to get a hold of them. So this is the actual device itself, and you can actually very easily get into and work on the sides. This does, if you were gonna buy the Corsair version, it does allow you to do things like upgrade the NVMe storage. It's the same thing on this side. All you gotta do is remove this, and then you can get to the screws and open them up. Okay, so you have to really listen for this thing to actually be on. Inside, looks like we have a couple Corsair applications. We have the Corsair launcher, and then we have this Corsair dashboard, which shows the active RGB effect, and then it's got the active RGB color. You can see the coolant temperature. Looks like you do have some software control of the actual stuff as well. But if you look at the front here, you swipe up and then you wait until the color you want is there. You press and hold,
It'll change. Oh no, I think it's below the power button. There you go. And then that changes the type.
You do have a way of just kind of playing with it. And then the best thing is if you really, well, best thing or not, you just hold it and it just shuts it off altogether. It's also got capacitive here. So if you hit this, lights it up so you can actually see your connections. And then when you're done, boom, turns off. This is a Falcon Northwest Tiki. So my other small form factor, this is a 13900 non-K and a 4080. This is a 14900K and a 4090. We're gonna do some comparisons later on, but I did wanna show that off because again, it makes sense given we have another small form factor PC to kind of throw it in there and take a look. So now let's see how this thing actually performs. Typically a 14900K will get anywhere between 35,000 and 40,000. So it'll just be interesting to see what this one ends up with from a Cinebench score. And again, we test a lot of these things live. So you might be saying, Robey, why do you remember stuff like that? That's why. And there will be a live stream for this. I know you're watching this on Monday when it comes out, but if you wanna see our full review, we're gonna basically be doing it all live, showing you gaming, all that stuff. You should definitely tune into our stream, which will be happening on 5/9 at 4 p.m. Pacific time. And then you can also, if that's already happening, you're watching this later, you can check that actually out right here. You see our 14900K here, it's idling at 38, 37, so that's actually pretty good. Let's just see what our temps and start stuff are. So we're gonna hit start. And guys, this is in our official test facility where we basically make sure the ambient and everything is the same. Look at temperatures right now, 7980. So temps are great, basically running full load. And it is, dude, you can't hear it. You cannot hear it at all. 36,000. Dude, how did they do that? I'll be honest, guys, I really thought that we were gonna get like a 34, 35. To pull 36,000, in a form factor like this is very impressive, which means if you wanted to use this for things like workstation tasks, stuff like that, you can absolutely do this. Dude, this is a 14900K and a 4090. Guys, very, very impressive. Sound wise, you know, it's heavy, you know, so, you know, as a traveling machine, maybe a little bit crazy, but for the most part, I mean, like, God, this is an engineering feat. And again, with Origin PC, you can actually customize it. So, yeah, let's wrap up this video. So, couple things. Number one, we did hear the fans kick on. Luckily, this is why I like having Brian around. He's like, you know, the fans do kick on after a little while. It's still insanely quiet, but I didn't wanna leave that out. And then the second thing is they actually have a second set of software, and you're probably seeing this in the B-roll right now, that's the Corsair launcher. And inside of that Corsair launcher, it's like an all-inclusive tool that shows you, like we did confirm I had 96 gigs of RAM. It shows you what they've actually installed, what applications are installed. It lets you optimize Windows. There's a lot to kind of dig in there, and we'll obviously dig in a little bit more when we get to the full review. There is a lot to consider when you're looking at a small form factor PC like the Corsair One, and a ton more that we could talk about with the Corsair i500, but we're gonna need a bit more time to really do its justice. That's the thing. We need to get more than just one day with the machine to give you a proper review, and we want to do it right by you. As we wrap this up, we want to give a huge shout out to Corsair and Origin PC for making this happen, for sending us this unit. This isn't sponsored. They did send us the unit for review. We do get to keep it. So I just want to be super clear on that stuff. But again, they're allowing us to do the review. There's no expectations whatsoever. But we want to know what you think about the new Corsair One. And more specifically, what you think about what Origin provides for it and where you would get it. Would you buy just a base Corsair One and do the upgrade yourself? Or would you like to configure it like you could with Origin PC? Do you like the redesign from where the Corsair One was before? Outside of specific parts, is there any other customization option you'd like to see on a PC like this one? Let us know all that down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post videos like this right here at Robeytech. Also, if you have questions, you want to talk more about the customization or this particular system or your PC build in general, head on over to discord.gg/Robeytech. Amazing place to talk to other like-minded PC and tech enthusiasts. And you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, feel free to follow us on all the other social media channels at Robeytech, absolutely everywhere. Thank you so much for watching this video, and look forward to seeing you on the next one.